Hi you guys, this is Lucius, back with another workout for you. So we'll start today discussing the challenge. So I think a challenge that's good right now for you guys would be to try and draw something. Many of you guys are artistic, some of you might not be so artistic, but I think everyone can benefit from trying to express themselves with drawing, with whatever materials and mediums you have. So it could be crayons, or it could be pencils or pens or whatever. And one thing that I did a number of years ago was I drew my room and all of the details in it. And that's something that you can have and look back on years from now and have an actual record of what a room in your apartment looked like during the coronavirus pandemic. Just an idea, a creative challenge for you guys. So as far as the workout's concerned, we're gonna be doing the so-called Bleep Test. It's also called the Beep Test. It's just a fitness standard that's sometimes used in the military. I've never actually done this particular version of it, but I have done so-called shuttle runs, which is just another type of test that involves running, sprinting. And so before I get into the details, I'll just, we should do a little warm-up. So the warm-up is gonna be 5 rounds of 20 meter sprint plus broad jumps and then also a little bit of calf stretches. So I wouldn't start up too quick, but you're just gonna do some running. So run 20 meters out, and then when you get to 20 meters, you're gonna do broad jumps back. And so usually it's standing broad jump. You're just gonna, wherever you're standing, jump as far as you can and jump back for 20 meters. And then when you get back to where you started, you're gonna do a little bit of calf stretch, which is best done against a wall or some other object. And just lean forward, try to get a good stretch in your calves, 20 seconds each side, and then do the sprint again. And so 5 sprints in total, and then 5 rounds of broad jump back in total, and then calf stretch twice. 20 seconds, so for each side. And so, yeah, the workout itself. So for this workout, you're gonna need to have a mobile device of some sort. The best way to do this workout is to do it outside, because that will allow you to run. I don't think it would be best like in a backyard area or a hoof. Probably better to do it out like in the park somewhere. And you're gonna have to have your smartphone or some computer, and hopefully with sufficient volume, because you're gonna need to hear the beeps, because those indicate when you the time you have to run the 20 meters. And so you're gonna mark out 20 meters, you're gonna need to measure it somehow, and use 2 cones or a couple shirts or whatever you've got to mark the distance. And when you start the video, you have to run from point A to point B before you hear the second beep. And as soon as you hear the second beep, then you run back. And as soon as you hear another beep, you run again. And so the trick is the beeps get, the interval between the beeps get shorter and shorter, and so you have less and less time to actually finish that 20 meter run. And at some point, it becomes impossible. So it's a little bit like a lot of those death by CrossFit workouts where the bar keeps getting raised until it's just not possible to hang with it anymore. And so I was just reading online a little bit. Apparently a really good score for the beep test is to do like up to the round of 10, which is usually 10 minutes, or higher, which means that you would be running something like, I guess it would be 14 kilometers an hour, something like that. So if you can maintain that speed after all the running you've done before, then that's considered high fitness. And so, yeah, so let us know how far you got on this, what level you got to, and have fun with it. And as soon as you're done, then you can do a few cool down stretches. First one is just the hurdler stretch. So there's 2 different ways to do the hurdler stretch. There's the easy version, which is with the one leg in front, like this, and just lean forward, try to bring your forehead to your knee, or just reach as far as you can and try to bring your chest as far forward as you can. Either way, the more advanced version is where you actually have the other leg behind you like this, and that creates a whole different dimension to the stretch because it's also getting this quad and hip flexor into it. And so do 1 minute each side on that, And then the second movement is going to be the happy baby pose, which, not one I usually do, but I think it's a good one because you're going to be using your hamstrings and your quads a lot, so you need to definitely work on your legs after this workout. And so for this one, you're just going to bring your legs up like this, as if you're giving birth, and then you're going to stretch your legs out like this and just get a nice stretch going. So do that one for a couple minutes as well. And that's the cool down, and I hope you guys enjoy the workout. Hopefully there's good weather. So enjoy it, take care. Talk to you soon, bye.